Hello everyone, this is Professor Manoj Shetty. Now, I'll be talking about something, how you score a max score in a GA for GATE. Also, the pitfalls to be avoided for the GA in the GATE examination. But before I start, let me tell you the big importance of GA in the GATE examination. 15 marks are allotted for GA. I have two stories to be told to you. There's a student of mine who is in the early 300 ranks. Ironically, he hasn't scored a single mark in the GA. Now, imagine a scenario where he had scored a score in a GA. He would have been a top 100 rankers and he would have landed up getting into IIT Mumbai instead of the IIT he actually went to. Another guy from mechanical who's in the early 500 ranks hasn't done very well in the GA. Same scenario, had he worked slightly harder or had he attempted the GA much better, he would have been the early rankers. So, these are the biggest drawbacks for both the students. Had they worked on the GA or solved a couple of questions, they would have been a high rankers. If you are applying for PSU, let me tell you that if your rank is less than 300, only then they take a chance or they select you. So, GA becomes a huge section to you on the final day. You have 15 marks, approximately 10 marks are your con section and 5 marks is your verbal. Now, it's a huge syllabus for con, but luckily they rely on couple of arithmetic topic and DI. They are the lighter topics on the final day and one of the very scoring factor. Now, when I look at arithmetic, the topics they love is something like percentage, profit and loss, simple and compound interest, ratio and proportion. You're looking at numbers, you're looking in terms of speed, distance, time, time and verb. These are major topics. And they look at one topic, DI. Honestly, I think when you want to improve DI, there are two DI they look into it. One is a tabular form and one is a pie chart. If you're a very big cricket follower, you can actually, while watching cricket, improve your DI. First 10 overs, the batsman has scored this much. Next 10 overs, he's increased by this much. So what is the percentage change going on? DI is one of the most practical questions you'll get on the final day. Same way when you're looking in terms of a percentage. I'll give you a very average question. The length of a rectangle is increased by 20% and the breadth by 10%. Find the percentage increase in the area of the rectangle. The length of the rectangle is increased by 20% and the breadth by 10%. Find the percentage increase in the area of the rectangle. Now, normally we have done the sum in this way. We've taken it either as length into breadth, x into y, 1 into 1, something like this. I'm taking in terms of numbers. I'm assuming let both length and breadth be 100 each. So my initial area of the rectangle is say 10,000. Now my length is going by 20%. My breadth is increased by 10%. So my new area will become 120 into 110, which is 13,200. I started with 10,000, it has become 13,200, so it's gone up by 3,200. When I say percentage change, in this case is an increase, so percentage increase is 3,200 upon 10,000 into 100%. So you get this as 32%. Now this you could have done by taking L into B, 1 into 1, X into Y, 10 into 10 or 100 into 100. Now remember, it's a speed based examination. This is a very normal way of doing it. I'll show you a trick where I'm getting the same sum in flat 5 seconds. And the trick is, suppose your length changes by say 8% and your breadth by B%. Your percentage change is given by this trick or this shortcut. A plus B plus AB upon 100 in terms of percentage. Now, in this case, the value of A is 20 and the value of B is 10. So if I plug in here, it becomes something like this. So the same sum are solved in flat 5 seconds if I know the tricks. These are the tricks you'll require for solving your GA part. Now that part I'm talking in terms of the construction. Verbal is one of the most underrated and most neglected. Remember guys, even after you complete your GATE and you're going for an interview, your entire interview will be an English language interview. You need to work on your vocabulary. You need to work on your diction. You need to work on your grammar. In fact, one good part in our GA verbal is you get a lot of questions based on what you've done in the earlier school days. It's not something you're learning new. Work on your vocabulary. In case you find difficult getting it, read an English newspaper, especially the editorial column. There are words which you may not understand. Take it out. Check in the Google what exactly it means and make your own vocabulary. That will be a major factor advantage for you. Anybody who's got a good vocabulary will normally tend to do very well. Even the next sector which you've done in the earlier days, reading comprehension, a huge sector. Hardly for me, if I was solving a reading comprehension, I normally like to read the questions. What happens is it gives me a fair idea what the passage is talking about before I attempt it. But this is my way of doing it, not mandatory that you got to follow my way, but this is one of the ways which has worked for me on the final day. I'm once again repeating, the 15 marks can be a very huge factor on the final day. Please do not neglect it. It's gonna be a huge factor. Work on percentage, work on simple and compound interest, work on time in work, speed, distance, time, DR becomes important. In the verbal section, please work on your vocabulary, reading comprehension and the grammar. Wishing you all the best for your GATE examination. Thank you so much.